video is a story of me starting several projects and not finishing any of them because they weren't turning out the way that I hoped. So there is no conclusion. I do try on one of the projects at the end of the video, if you want to skip to that. But most of this video is going to be me working on things that don't really come to fruition. And there's some funny commentary, sort of funny commentary throughout the video, and me explaining what I'm doing. This video is mostly for me to watch and remember that when I try to make videos and sew things just for content, not because I have a plan and a vision and it's something I want to create, it doesn't really turn out all that well. So nobody is obligated to watch this video because it is pretty long. I understand that. It is what it is. And following that incredibly optimistic intro to the video.
I got some thrifted placemats and various things for a project to work on, just create something. And so I got these, like, seven of these plastic placemats, this kind of grandma old lady shawl. It was kind of see-through and kind of not. Wasn't sure what I was gonna do, but the gold went with the placemat, so. And then I got this very dark blue fitted sheet, and you know, blue and gold, it all tied together in my head, so I was like, okay, I'll use this. I started by undoing the fitted sheet, taking out the elastic that went all around. Thankfully, this kind was, like, it went all around and not just, like, a random stretch in the four corners, so I was able to, like, take it all out in one fell swoop, if you will. So my vision for this project was, like, I was gonna turn these placemats into, like a plasticky armor to go over, like, this ball gown. Not necessarily a ball gown. Ball gown implies a big skirt. But, like, just this, like, evening gown. And I felt like it's something I'd seen before, but I was not able to find, like, any reference pictures. This is me taking out the stitches that make it like the fitted sheet a square to turn it flat. Basically, that's what I'm doing. My plan was to turn these placemats into like a corset armor type of vibe, but I had so much trouble finding any sort of like reference picture or idea, and so I was pretty much going off my own imagination. I had nothing to work off of, which ends up causing problems later, as you can see. This is me taking it out because it didn't lay right and I wanted to take it in a little bit, but since it's plastic, I had to like undo all the seams and it was just a big huge pain in the butt, basically.
I've sewed these four pieces together, but they don't exactly lay quite as flat as I would like. It's also very long, so what I think I'm gonna do is have it lay like this and then kind of cut it off halfway. Such a difficult material to work around. I could use it to make like a belt or like shoulder pads. I just have not been able to find any kind of inspiration photos on Pinterest or the like. So I'm going from my own brain. And it's going pretty slow. Because there's not much background knowledge, so.
Oh, this is me trying to drape something for the main portion of the gown, but I decided to use like a extra fabric so I wouldn't mess it up. This striped fabric also used to be a bed sheet, and I've had it for years, and it's my go-to draping fabric because I never use it for anything. But I came up with some sort of fabric draping, evidently, since I ended up cutting it out eventually. Yeah, still trying to figure out how to make this plastic thing work. It just was not looking right. Maybe I should have left it. I don't know. So this is what I ended up draping. I had kind of one dart thing down the middle, and then it was just stretched around it. And I was planning on doing like a scooping neckline.
Why is this way harder than it needs to be?
Clearly I was enjoying myself already. But here I am cutting out the thing that I draped. And it just, there's a lot of guesswork that goes into what I sew, and normally it turns out fine, but in this case, with this project, it was, the whole thing was pretty much a train wreck. Let's be honest. I don't really know what I'm trying to do here, but, I think I'm just putting the mock-up on to see how the plastic thing looks over it. Probably, yeah. Okay, so I tried to take it in and it didn't work. So now my only option is to cut it off. So here I am measuring where I should like cut off this thing, chop it off. Obviously, I'm just gonna eyeball it because measuring is for losers. And yeah, then I cut it, which was pretty scary because I only have so much of these placemats. But at this point, I was contemplating if I even wanted to finish this project because I was already hating it. So I didn't really care because, you know, I wasn't super confident that it was really gonna end up as anything anyway. Which is really sad because I should be really enjoying what I'm doing, but I was not with this project specifically. But once I cut it, it did lay nice, and I wasn't super bothered by the fact that it was short. I felt like it was kind of a vibe. I feel like maybe people do that. But now I am measuring a piece to go around the back so that it can close. There's not really all that much to explain about what I'm doing here. I'm pretty much just cutting a rectangle, but I'm slightly like angling the sides like a trapezoid so that it fits the kind of cone-shapedness of a human torso. It's not really that complicated. But then I'm going to sew that on the machine and stitch down the seam allowances. Not that it matters that I tell you any of this, because I ended up, never mind, I won't tell you what I did yet. You'll have to watch and find out. So as you can see here, it went all the way around. Woohoo! Not that I was worried, because even if it was too small, it would lace up, and I didn't care. I'm sorry I'm so pessimistic. I'm just really bothered by this project. It's just so disappointing when you just really want to create something, but nothing works out. That basically describes my entire weekend, by the way. Because not only did I work on this project, I also worked on two others, so three in total, and none of them I finished because I hated all of them. I think what I need to do is get like hordes of fabric that I can actually work with, because I didn't have really anything of this substantial size that I could use to make what I wanted. Like, I didn't have enough, and so that was kind of part of what was keeping me from like really creating something, because I was just scrounging. Here I'm putting it on the mannequin. As you can see, I could have even tapered it more in the back. See how it's kind of overlapping weird? Okay, now I am making the pattern draft for the back of the dress, bodice, whatever you'd like to call it, shirt. Using the same fabric, I just used a rectangle, and I didn't even go up all the way up the shoulder, because I was planning on tying it with like some sort of clasp, but I should have gone all the way up, because I just guessed. And here I'm attacking with the pen, marking the back of the middle of the back, and the armhole. And then I was gonna cut it out on my bedsheet. So I took the pattern draft that I made and cut it up the seam so that it was like the size I needed to cut out, but minus the seam allowance. So I was gonna have to add the seam allowance as I cut it, which is fine because I do that anyway because I don't know why. But I have just always done that, even if, like, the pattern has seam allowance, I always cut extra. And then it causes problems because when I sew, my seams are pretty narrow. So it always ends up being a little too big. But anyway. This is the bodice. Yes. I kept getting confused because it was so high-necked. But anyway. I digress. See the seam allowance that I'm cutting there? Yep. I like to think I'm being pretty consistent with it, but the fabric was like stretchy and kind of wrinkled, which caused problems later, but I won't tell you what kind of problems, but I'm sure you can guess. And this is cutting out the back. Again, seam allowance, the wrinkles, everything. Perfect storm. Perfect storm. Not really very perfect, but. Okay, here, it didn't go all the way up, as I told you, and so I just guessed on a shape. And I curved it. You'll see. Oh my gosh. I wish I had cut it a little wider at the top. But look how I curved it. Anyway, I don't know what I was planning on doing with that shape, but that's what I did. So here I had cut out like identical pieces of that shawl fabric and I sewed them together. And this is kind of how it turned out. As you can see, I tie them together at the top, kind of what I was thinking. But the shiny fabric did not stretch, and I wasn't planning on that, and this is why it does not fit, because the bedsheet itself stretched when I was, like, draping it. Ugh.
So, the plan was to put these little grommets into these plastic hot mess. You know, it goes around. I was gonna grommet it. I was testing out this thing, my grommet putter inner, to see if it could potentially punch the hole for me. Can. And it's not fabric, so it's not going to fray, so I feel like it doesn't need grommets. But it looks so good with the grommet. That's with the grommet versus without a grommet. I dropped it. Shoot. Oh. So, I don't feel like wasting my grommets on this. Because it's already going so badly. I mean, look at it. It looks like something you'd see on one of those fashion competition shows. And then they lose. It's that bad. So, until I become incredibly motivated to put my heart and soul into this project, I'm not using my grommets. That's all I wanted to say. Okay. Now I'm gonna just make holes, but I should probably measure. That's what smart crafters do. Okay, eyeballed it. Looks roughly an inch. So I'm just gonna hope for the best here. Oh, that worked so well. Okay, so I hate it. It looks so stupid and not cohesive. I don't know if I just need to take this off and try to make something with like the glittery fabric and just give up on these placemats, or scrap the entire project, which is what I'm leaning towards because I'm just so over it. That's what the back looks like. Flapping in the wind slightly. But,
this is the beginning of what came to be the second and third projects. I had a large rectangle of white fabric, and I'm just hemming it here. I was going to turn it into a skirt, so I hemmed it and gathered it. This is leftover fabric from the Barbie Annalise dress, and I'm cutting out the same shape as I did back when I made that dress, which is the center bodice panel. I ended up altering the shape I cut out a few times because it wasn't super symmetrical, but I ended up making that sort of V shape. Then I started to drape the rest of the bodice with this leftover fabric, which was also from the Barbie Annalise dress that I made. Super creative of me. Basically recreate it. Yep. I then cut out all the pieces that I needed for the front and back of the bodice out of this pink fabric. I think this is me figuring out how the back is gonna go. Most likely. I then sewed all of those pieces together, and I started this project a few months ago actually, so I'm not entirely sure what I was doing, because I filmed all of this in like October, and I'm voice recording and editing this in December, so I apologize. Okay, this is where we're at with all the pieces sewn together, and I'm ironing that down. Can't remember if I did a lining. I think I did. It's probably later. I am hot gluing on ribbons to the edges of the bodice, of the center panel, to cover the seams, I presume. And this is the last piece of footage I have from this time, because after I did this, I think I gave up. I may have sewed straps, I don't remember.
Okay, here's the top. It's not long enough to cover the waistband. But it's also pretty low cut. This is the top. I did add straps, and there is a felt lining, or felt, yeah, it's felt. It's just too short. Should be longer. But considering everything, it's not that bad. This is the skirt from the Barbie dress. I added a bum roll, hip padding things. I think that helps with this, but see how it is above the waistband? Yeah, I wish it was longer. But there's the back. Interesting. There's not boning in it anywhere. The straps are kind of at the wrong angle. I think the straps were supposed to go over the tips of the shoulders like this instead of straight up and down. But yeah. That's the end of the video. Pretty disappointing, but that's what you get when you are pumping out sewing projects with no plan, like me. Okay, that's all.